two to the perfect push.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another great episode of HHM TV. I am Chris, and with me, as always, is Brock. And today, we are going to highlight a very special monthly celebration in the month of February, which is American Heart Month. And today, we thought, what a better idea to talk about American Heart Month than to come up to a place that is focused on health and heart health as well. Brock, where are we?
We are at OPS, Optimum Performance Sports, Chris, and this is a great facility. So many resources, so many tools to get in good health, good heart health. And with us today is Jill. Jill, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Okay, so let's just get right to it. For folks that want to focus on being a little more heart healthy, maybe let's dispel some of the myths in a, how do you get started? What's really important? It's really about taking that first step, isn't it?
Right. The first step is to get yourself into the door. And then it's to show up. And it can be as easy as starting to walk for 20 to 30 minutes a day. Once you make that a routine, then you can start taking it to a more advanced level. But you've got to start in an easy and safe way, and don't get discouraged.
Yeah.
You gotta start with those baby steps.
Absolutely. Right. So we are here in their performance gym, which I myself have gone through a number of Jill's workouts. They are incredible. They also make you very tired. So she does a great job. But Jill, there are some things that people can do, even at home, if they're trying to get warmed up to be able to come to this part of the gym. This is not necessarily for everyone. This is for people who want to push themselves a little bit extra.
Right.
What are some of the basics that people can cover?
Starting with body weight exercises. So a lot of it's stretching and mobility and just getting your body warm. Mm-hmm. So those are things we start off with very easily here. Make you comfortable, make sure that you are doing it in a safe way, and then we will progress you to be able to do these adult performance workouts.
Great.
Because I think the goal at the end of the day, right, the heart is a muscle. It needs to be worked out. We need to get the blood pumping and sort of stressed a little bit,
yep,
right, to get the heartbeat going a little bit more than just at a resting pace. So really anything along those lines. It could be push-ups, it could be light weightlifting, walking, cycling.
Yeah.
It's kind of all right here, isn't it?
Yeah, we have it all right here.
Jill, you also do personal training here, right?
Yes.
So how does that look for somebody who's looking to come in and take that commitment with you?
Yeah, well, we start with all different levels. I've got people that just want to move with their grandkids. They want to get off the floor easier.
Yeah.
And if those are our goals, that's what we're going to work on. If you are more advanced and you're looking for somebody to really push you, we can do that as well. So we've got all different levels. We just need to get you in for a membership.
Sure.
And then we can start with whatever's comfortable for you. Maybe it's once a week. Maybe you need more accountability and you want to come three times a week. We can make that happen.
Okay, so Jill, if somebody's got a treadmill at home or they're into that whole idea of let's just get started with walking, like how do we optimize that for better heart health?
Okay, so I would find a comfortable pace and walk there for 3 to 4 minutes, and then either take your incline up 0.5 or increase your speed 0.5. And then if that gets to be too much, bring it back down. And then you can kind of hit those intervals that way. So 2 minutes walking, maybe 1 minute of jogging, and then bring it back down to that walk.
Okay.
So that's a great way to build your stamina and your endurance.
Gotcha.
So let's talk a little bit about the optimum heart range that people want to be in when they're exercising, right? Because it's different for everybody, right?
Yes. 220 minus your age is going to give you your max heart rate.
Okay.
Anything over that 60% of your max heart rate is where you want to try to be. That 60 to 75% is going to put you in a fat burning zone.
Okay.
Anything that's 80% and above is going to be high intensity.
Okay.
So when you first start, you might kind of hit those higher ranges, but as your heart gets stronger, you're going to notice that you have to work harder to get that higher heart rate.
Okay.
Yeah. And I think, you know, the other misnomer then is I gotta work harder, so I gotta do it longer. Not necessarily, but change the incline up more or the speed up more, whatever can help get you into that heart range,
right? Yeah, you could take a 20-minute workout and make the intensity harder.
Yeah.
And you're still gonna get that calorie expenditure that you want.
Gotcha.
All right, Jill, so if somebody wants to get set up and get started, where can they find you and how can they get a hold of you guys?
Okay, so look us up at OptimumPerformanceSports.com or you can search for OPS Fitness Club.
Okay.
And you can call and make an appointment or just come into the lobby during business hours and we will get you started. For February, we have zero enrollment.
Awesome.
Nice.
And what we'll run for you guys, anybody that is watching this ad and you come in here and say that you saw it, we'll give you a free t-shirt as well.
Dude, okay. Free swag. Love it.
Yeah, so just say you saw this on HHM TV, zero enrollment for you in February, and a free t-shirt. Not a bad deal, Chris.
No, can't go wrong with that. I've got three of them myself. I love them. You're going to love them too when you come in here and mention the video.
There you go. So that's going to do it for another episode of HHM TV. I'm Brock East Chris.
Go find the great things in your community.
We'll see you next time.